of winning the title.
Let's see how the other two promoted teams got on, starting with leaders Plymouth, who would clinch the title with victory at Grimsby.
The Green Army Party Brigade were in full voice at Blundell Park. That was until the wind was sucked out of their sails, thanks to Sean Pearson's strike inside the opening 60 seconds. The Mariners' early shot that struck the bow of Argyle's title challenge certainly rocked Derek Adams' side, but Jimmy Spencer's equaliser made sure the ship wasn't going down without an almighty fight. A winner would have been the buoyancy aid needed to guarantee Plymouth stayed in top spot, but Sonny Bradley's late miss would leave the door ajar for Portsmouth to pounce.
And not a spare seat in the house as the outsiders in the three-horse race look to do their bit at Fratton Park. And there's nothing like an own goal completely out the blue to settle the nerves. The true definition of a huge slice of luck, courtesy of Daniel O'Shaughnessy's right shin pad. Shocking own goal aside, Cheltenham actually more than matched Pompey up until the hour mark, when Carl Bennett popped up with a deflected goal his excellent contribution deserved. And that all-important second would spark a second-half goal spree. 4 minutes later, Bennett, this time the architect, with a perfectly weighted ball for Cal Naismith to make it three. And news soon filtered through of Hartlepool's goal. Pompey moved top of the league, and substitute Jamal Rowe celebrated by smashing home a fourth. As Cheltenham's thoughts well and truly shifted to cocktails and sandy beaches, Gary Roberts was hauled down by Liam Davis. Penalty Portsmouth, and Gareth Evans didn't let a slip distract him from converting the penalty. With Pompey fans no doubt across events at Grimsby and Hartlepool, James Dayton's superb solo goal did little to dampen the mood. And there was still time for the home side to grab a sixth. Naismith's second of the afternoon and 15th of the season was the last of the action on the south coast. That is until all 17,500 Portsmouth fans flooded the pitch at the final whistle to celebrate a truly remarkable title win on the final day, having never previously been top of the table at any stage of the season.
Wherever the trophy is, whether it's in Hartlepool or Grimsby, they need to get it down to Portsmouth as quickly as they can, because we're going to enjoy it.
It was in Grimsby, Paul, but I'm sure it's on the way. Adam, what a finish to the season. You heard that. They've not been top all season, then this brilliant run, 31 points from the last 36.
Yeah, momentum.
Just a dip for the line.
Yeah, I mean, momentum's absolutely massive, George, and when you've got a defensive basis like he's got, and you've got the best defence in the league, they haven't really got an out-and-out goal scorer, but they've got goals within their side. I mean, Naismith had a great, you know, end of the season, scoring plenty of goals. You know, Gary Roberts is still rolling back the years there, but, you know, he's been there with Chesterfield. He knows what it takes to get out of that league, but it's a massive football club, isn't it? And to deal with that pressure from the fans, you know, it's a testament to him.
Well, Doncaster fans feel their side, Clinton, has blown this, having been well clear.
Yeah, they were there or thereabouts for nearly the whole season. I think the last two or three games, they've not really turned up. And it...